Hi there. Welcome to Director's Commentary for the Prologue for Gotham Knights. My name is Wilson Mui, and I'm the Cinematics Director at WB Games Montreal. The Prologue was quite the storytelling challenge, as we needed to say goodbye to Bruce and welcome the Batman family into the fray, all while exploring the aftermath of Bruce's death. I'd like to explore with you some of the behind-the-scenes concepts and storyboards for this very epic cinematic sequence in our game.
If you're watching this, I'm dead.
After intercepting the code black message, our establishing beauty shot teases the viewer with our version of the Batcave, complete with a redesigned Batmobile. As Batman staggers off the Batmobile, you can even catch glimpses of some of the vehicles in his garage, including a prototype of the Batcycle on the hoist. We worked together with the super talented Bear McCurry to craft the epic score for the Prologue.
We are done, you and I.
With a central theme for Batman throughout the sequence. The initial beats reflect Batman's heartbeat before he pulls out the arrow, setting the mood right from the start. With a demonic shaped mask, the assassin bears an ornate emblem on his armor, identifying him as a member of the League of Shadows, an ancient and secret society with a long history with Batman. We worked with our stunt coordinator, Darren Ross, and his team from LA to work on the epic choreography for the entire fight sequence. It was key to establish that this was not a fight that Batman was going to win.
You spent years trying to fight this war, and for what? Corruption still flourishes in Gotham, lurking in every shadow.
You don't need that mask. I know it's you, Ra's al Ghul.
You allowed this blasphemy, this sacrilege.
The reveal of Ra's al Ghul brings a familiar face to Batman. During this fight sequence, we brought back some of Batman's signature moves, including his cape shield and cape deflection, as he temporarily disables Ra's al Ghul with a flashbang from his utility belt.
This city is still under my protection.
As an homage to comics and films, you will see signature elements of the Batcave, including the T-Rex statue, Two-Face's coin, the Riddler statue, and the Joker's card. The reveal of the Batcomputer has a lot of information on screen. If you look closely, we tease the Batman family as we see them fighting crime in Gotham City. Unknown to Batman at the time, the shurikens are embedded with bombs that are timed to detonate after impact.
Deal with you myself.
The unique design of Ra's sword is accompanied by a rope attachment that, once connected together, allows for a broader strike range. Notice the encrusted jewels lighting up as it connects, teasing his internal Lazarus power, which he can channel, making him more powerful.
Why fine? It will be over soon!
Built for hand-to-hand combat, Batman's suit has padded limbs for blocking, with a light interior for mobility, perfect for an older Batman who is still at the top of his fighting game. The fight atop the Batwing served several purposes. It was a high point in the Batcave and gave a godlike perspective to the fight. It was the reveal of a redesigned Batwing, and it was an epic battle of giants on a battleground that shifted mid-fight. The constant back-and-forth barrage of hits is pretty raw, with each of their attacks more impactful than the previous. Built between the iconic waterfalls, the training facility is encased in the side of the Batcave and eventually leads up to Wayne Manor.
You should know by now that you cannot defeat me. I am eternal!
Gracious line, "I am eternal," is a direct reference to his use of the Lazarus pits to make him immortal, and he escalates the fight by triggering his Lazarus power during this part of the fight. To balance this, we wanted to showcase Batman's weapon prowess and his reflex to be able to use everything at his disposal.
Unlike you, I'm not afraid of dying. I'd rather keep my humanity.
Although briefly incapacitated by Batman, Ra's is unfazed and is ready to strike back with a vengeance. Bruce's painful arrival to the top floor is a powerful moment as he realizes at this point he will set in motion Code Black, his final failsafe plan. Having a private moment to say goodbye to the Batman family, closing the gate to Wayne Manor to seal in Ra's, triggering the bat sonar, and arming the strategically placed bombs around the Batcave are all part of the plan. Last thing left to do is to bait the trap and lead Ra's in.
You'll be dead before they get here. Your precious family. I will slaughter them. One by one. And when they have drawn their last breaths, I will burn the city to the ground.
You won't get a chance.
The flutter of the bats escaping is iconic of the Batcave.
Gotham is their city now.
The Code Black Protocol is the final failsafe to protect the Batman family and Gotham City. It triggers an epic explosion of the Batcave, Wayne Manor, and everything inside. Here we fast forward to a haunting scene, the aftermath of the explosion and what is left of Wayne Manor. As our heroes arrive first on the scene, you'll notice the dying bat on the ground, meant to foreshadow the death of Bruce as the bat has its final breath. This last transmission is a harsh message, but is something Bruce would have prepared well in advance as someone who has always had a backup plan.
If you're watching this, I'm dead. This is a Code Black. This message was automatically triggered when I destroyed the cave and everything it contained. I know what's coming won't be easy.
There! With chills to the spine, the haunting feeling of the score resonates the dreadful and brooding discovery that our heroes are about to make.
But then. Nothing we do is easy.
The emotional impact of this reveal is unforgettable.
I've prepared for it as best as I can.
With the battle scars and wounds from the final fight with Ra's, Bruce is still clutching his bat cowl until the bitter end.
I know you have to.
This cowl will be the same one you'll find in the belfry later in the game.
I'm sorry it's come to this.
The last shot of the sequence ends with Nightwing removing the cowl as they move Bruce from the rubble, making sure to remove any remnants that would connect Bruce Wayne as Batman.
We both know it won't take long for Gotham's criminals to realize the Batman is gone. We can't count on the GCPD.
We meet one of our factions in the game here, the Mob, as they're in the midst of a high-speed chase and shootout with the GCPD. They are well-armed, brash, and rampant in Gotham City now that Batman is nowhere to be seen.
I'm leaving you the Belfry as the base of operations. Some of the technology is outdated, but it has the gear you need and all of my files.
The Belfry and the streets here are the actual ones from the open world, and this particular storefront gives a sneak peek of some of the events from the game.
Many of you knew Bruce from Gotham's celebrity pages. A handsome, charming billionaire.
With a state funeral for Bruce Wayne, notice the presence of GCPD to keep this a smaller controlled event, with key public figureheads present, including Jacob and Catherine Kane.
He was my nephew.
Closest to family, Dick and Tim are with Alfred next to the casket, while Barbara and Jason, as outsiders, stand as part of the crowd. If you look closely in the back, you'll see another familiar face, Talia al Ghul.
I want to tell you this. Bruce was Gotham. He loved this city more than he loved anything. He was a protector to this city. He worked tirelessly behind the scenes to bring justice and equality. There's nothing he wouldn't do. No project he wouldn't champion if he thought Gotham would benefit. And I think in remembering that, we remember Bruce as he truly was.
As Alfred approaches the casket, the heavier rain amplifies his sadness when he says his last personal goodbye to Bruce. Notice you'll see an outline of the bat symbol together with a color palette of grays, blacks, and dark blues, which stand for the colors of Batman.
You've always had my back when I needed you. I know you'll keep Gotham safe. Good luck. And goodbye.